All right, welcome back, everybody, and welcome anybody new that's watching. So I'm going to start this off a little different than I normally do my videos, but got a lot of explaining to do to begin with, and then probably go out in the field and do some shooting. So every once in a while, you get something stuck in your head that you don't want to do it at first, and then you end up doing it anyway. So what I'm talking about is these little 32 ACP pistols that I got here. One of them is a Beretta Model 81. It's really cool. It's like a small version of a 92 FS or an M9, even though I think it came out prior to the 92 or 92 FS. But it's very, very similar. It's just smaller. I mean, you can kind of see in the video here. Not a real good background, but you can just see that it's smaller. Smaller version of it. Controls work the same for the most part. Other than the 92 FS has like the defrocker, right? Where this Model 81 just has a safety. See, it doesn't decock, it just has a safety. So, why did I buy it? A guy I know has had these for sale for some time. And I guess just like any other addict, I get something in my head and then eventually it just takes over and then I have to do it. So. The reason I didn't buy these to begin with is because 32 ACP is really kind of difficult to find right now. But I've been able to find a small supply of it, and so I decided to buy these. What the other one is, this is an Astra Unceta CIA Model A50. I don't know if I said that right. It's made in Spain. Have no idea if I'm pronouncing it right, so forgive me if I'm not. The cool thing about this one is it's very similar to this Walther PPKS. Disassembly is very similar, and the feel, ergonomics of it is very similar. And it's actually a nicely made little handgun. It feels good and solid. I haven't shot these yet, so we're going to go out and shoot them in a little while. But it feels good. Now, obviously that's a cleared weapon. I'm going to dry fire it. Very nice, crisp trigger, okay? But I guess the major difference between that and the PPKS, this is obviously clear as well. Okay, so, well, the PPKS, you can do a double action shot. This Astra, you cannot. The hammer has to be rocked back. Okay, so it's single action only. Where this is a double action, right? So, double action, single action, whatever. Like I said, these have been weighing on me for several months, and finally I decided, you know, once I found a little ammo supply, I decided to buy them. So, 32 ACP, gosh, what is it? 32 ACP was developed, well, by John Browning back in the late 19th century, I believe. Developed for FN, if I recall correctly, if my information that I read is correct. And here you can see, let's go ahead, I'm going to move the camera. Zoom in just a little bit. So here you can see, on the right, you have a 9mm, you know, 9x19, 9mm parabellum, whatever you call it, 9mm. Then you have 380 ACP right here, and then this is 32 ACP. Okay. Obviously, it's not going to be as powerful as a 380, or obviously not a 9mm either. But what is it any good for home defense, right? Or self-defense? I don't know. I would imagine. It's been around a long time. I mean, obviously, it's not going to blow somebody's lung out like old Joe says the 9mm will do. But pretty neat little guns. I'm really, really happy with this Beretta. I mean, anybody that has served in the United States military over the past 40 years is probably familiar with this platform, this 92FS, the M9 platform, right? It's very similar to that. So I was real happy when I seen this. And I was going to buy it initially, but I just couldn't find any ammo for it at the time. So now that I'm finding a little bit of ammo supply, I decided to buy these, and we're going to try them. So, as you can see, it operates exactly like the 92FS. You can fire a single action shot or a double action shot with the Beretta Model 81. Pretty cool. The only problem I ran into with buying these is that they only came with one magazine each. And I was able to find some magazines from Beretta USA for these. I'm kind of having a little bit of trouble finding new magazines for these. This is for the Astra, okay. And then for the Beretta, I was able to order some straight from Beretta USA. So I guess let's go ahead. We'll go out into the field. I'll set up a target. I'll do some accuracy testing, and then I got a block of ballistic gel. We'll go ahead and compare what these hollow points do. We'll go ahead and compare it with the 380 and the 9mm, and just see where the 32 ACP measures up. And maybe if you're thinking about getting one, or if you have one, and you use it for everyday carry, maybe you might see how it stacks up against these other two common ammunitions. So let's get ready and we'll go out in the field. Okay, out here at the range, first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to do a group test with both of these little 32 ACPs, the Beretta and then also the Astra. So we'll start with the Beretta. I'm really excited to shoot that one. Just one of those things, real excited to shoot it. So we'll do a grouping exercise. We'll shoot a three-shot group, just for the hell of it, and see how it groups. And then we'll do the same thing with the Astra. And then once we're done with that, we'll put it in ballistic gel, the 32 ACP, the 380, and the 9mm, and see how they compare. So let's get started. Okay, I'll shoot at the top dot here. You'll see the target in a second. I'll shoot at the top dot with this, and then with the Astra, I'll shoot at the bottom dot. Okay, here we go. Okay, it made a nice little group at 10 yards, the Beretta did. So let's see how the Astra does. Okay, here we go, bottom dot. Wow. That was a fantastic group. It's a little high and a little bit right, but this is only 10 yards, so I can live with that, with this ammo. The ammunition I'm using is just a bronze, PMC bronze, full metal jacket, no big deal. We'll use a PMC bronze in the ballistic gel, and it looks like a Hornady bullet, and the rest of the 380 and the 9mm will also be a Hornady hollow point. So let's get started with the ballistic gel. Okay, so I'm going to shoot the 9mm first because I expect it to have the best penetration. And then I'll go on to the 380 and then the 32 ACP. And we'll see what happens. I got two cameras, one set up on both sides of the ballistic gel, and then we'll see how they compare. I'll pick the best, clearest video. Okay, so here is a Glock 43X. I chose it because it's got a similar barrel length to both the 380 and also the 32 ACP. So here we go. Let's have to squat down just a little bit to get good and level with the ballistic gel. Thank you. Okay, looks like we got a hit. We'll check the penetration real quick. Okay, looks like the 9mm went all the way through. I'm going to try a different style of 9mm bullet and see if we can capture one. It's a hollow point, but it's just a different brand of hollow point. Okay, we got an impact. Let's check the penetration. Okay, we captured that bullet. Let's go ahead and try the 380 hollow point and see if we can capture one of those. Here we go. Let's see how we did. Okay, we've got a bullet captured. Let's go ahead and try this 32 ACP and see where it goes. And you can obviously see already in the ballistic gel, the 9mm penetrates way further than the 380. So here we go, let's try the 32. All right, let's check the impact. Okay, this is very interesting. We didn't get any expansion on that 32 ACP hollow point. That's at 10 yards. So I'm gonna move in to about 5 yards and see if we can get that bullet to expand. Very interesting. Okay, so I moved in about half the distance. So it's about 5 or 6 yards. So we'll fire another shot with this 32 ACP and see if we can get that bullet to expand. That was interesting. So all right, let's see how we did. Okay, we did capture a bullet. It does not look like there's hardly any expansion in there whatsoever. Got it from this camera angle. Looks like no expansion on that bullet with the 32 ACP. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna move in a couple of more yards and see if we can get that bullet to expand, that 32 ACP. So here we go. Okay, that's about a 3 yard shot, and it looks like we did get some expansion maybe out of that bullet. A lot of penetration at 3 yards, maybe not much expansion. So this is kind of interesting. Obviously we know it's a low powered round, but even at close range doesn't look like we'll get much expansion out of this hollow point. So you might have to get kind of creative if you're looking for a hollow point for expansion if you're using a 32 ACP. So just for the heck of it, I'm gonna throw a full metal jacket in and we'll see how that penetrates at 10 yards and see what it does. Okay, this is a full metal jacket 32 ACP. Let's see what kind of penetration it gets at 10 yards. Ah. looks like we got a hit. Let's see if it penetrated all the way through, like you'd expect a 9mm to do. Nine millimeter full metal jacket, I guess. Okay, so it does look like that went all the way through. I believe that is the full metal jacket, 32 ACP. This wound cavity right here. Okay, I went ahead and dug the bullets out of the ballistic gel. Obviously, this is the 9mm on the left. And I know the 9mm that penetrated all the way through. I know that was a Hornady. It was a critical defense route. I know that to be a fact. The 380, I was mistaken on the 380. It is actually a SIG Elite defense, is what this the 380 was. And I know these were PMC manufactures these. They look like Hornady bullets, but I don't know 100% for sure that they are. I'd probably do a little research and find out. They just look like it. Does PMC manufacture their own bullets? I don't know. Or do they buy them from somewhere else? But either way, they did not expand. And I don't think that has to do with the hollow point itself. I think that just has to do with the fact that 32 ACP just is not very powerful. And it is what it is. Is there hollow point ammo out there that will expand? Probably somewhere. But with what we have available where I live right now, probably not. So real quick, I'm going to run out back out of the field. I'm going to fire one more shot into that ballistic gel, point blank range, and see what it does, just for curiosity's sake. All right, let's go ahead and try this 32 ACP at about 2 feet, point blank range. Penetrated all the way through. I'll try it back from a yard. Okay, looks like we got one captured, but there is still no expansion. We know it'll penetrate, on a soft target. Now, is it going to be effective? Obviously, it's not going to be as effective as a 9mm or even, the 380 ACP. But I guess if that's what you got, it'll get the job done. It's kind of fun, messing around with this new... these new little handguns that I got. Is it something I'm going to use for everyday carry? Eh, maybe. Certain situations might warrant that. But it sure is fun. I mean, and they're just so cute. I mean, both of them have that ugly ass European, mid 20th century shape to them. They just, Here's that shape that I'm talking about. It's just ugly as sin, but beautiful at the same time, Just that, like I said, mid-20th century, ugly-ass European look. But I sure like it. I mean, anyway, a little presentation on 32 ACP. They're fun. Ammo's hard to find. So if you got one, stock up on what ammo you can. If you find it, buy a box. That's my advice on that. I know the sun's behind me. It's kind of a bad video situation with the sun where it is, but hey, do what we can do. Anyway, Beretta Model 81, the Astra Unceta Model A50. Pretty cool little pickups, I think. A little nice add to my collection. Anyway, have a great day.